If we take a look at the periodontium, the region where the oral mucosa meets the surface of the tooth is unique. Dentogingival junction is the junction between the tooth and the gingiva. This junction has many parts. Let us take a look. The invaginated area between the tooth and the gingival tissue is called the gingival sulcus. On an average, it has a depth of 0.5 to 3 mm. The floor of this sulcus and the epithelium cervical to it, which is attached to the tooth surface, is called junctional epithelium or attachment epithelium. The wall of the gingival sulcus is lined by an epithelium called oral sulcular epithelium or crevicular epithelium, which is stratified squamous non-keratinized type. It is continuous with the epithelium of the gingiva, which is stratified squamous keratinized type. The gingival sulcus contains a fluid called the gingival crevicular fluid. Now let us study the development of the dentogingival junction. During amelogenesis, the ameloblasts, after completing the formation of enamel, enter the post-secretory stage, during which the entire enamel organ constricts and forms reduced enamel epithelium, which is a 4 to 5 cell layered structure and is attached to the enamel by a basal lamina called primary enamel cuticle. As the tooth shows eruptive movements, the reduced enamel epithelium and the oral epithelium meet, fuse, and degenerate. Once the tooth emerges from the gingiva, the primary enamel cuticle on the exposed surface of the crown is called the Nasmyth's membrane, which soon gets removed by mechanical forces. At the junction of the gingiva and the tooth, a shallow groove develops called the gingival sulcus. Once tooth breaches the gingiva, the reduced enamel epithelium is called primary attachment epithelium, which as the tooth continues to erupt, gets shorter and shorter. The cells of the reduced enamel epithelium in the primary attachment epithelium are gradually replaced by cells from the sulcular epithelium, after which it is called secondary attachment epithelium. Moreover, the primary enamel cuticle is now called the secondary enamel cuticle. Junctional epithelium. The epithelium of the gingiva which gets attached to the tooth is called junctional epithelium or attachment epithelium. It extends up to 2 mm on the tooth surface. It has the highest turnover rate of 5 to 6 days. At the apical end, it is 3 to 5 cell layer thick, whereas at the coronal end, it is 15 to 30 cell layer thick. Junctional epithelium is the only epithelium which has two basal lamina at its two interfaces. At the connective tissue interface with no retipegs, it has the external basal lamina which is attached by hemidesmosomes. External basal lamina is continuous with the basal lamina of the circular epithelium and gingival epithelium. Now the second basal lamina which is at the enamel interface is called the internal basal lamina. The cells which are in direct contact with the internal basal lamina and have hemidesmosomes with it are called DAT cells. The combination of the hemidesmosomes and internal basal lamina attaching the junctional epithelium to the tooth is called epithelial attachment or attachment apparatus. That is, epithelial attachment is the union between junctional epithelium and the tooth. Junctional epithelium is highly permeable. This permits movement of fluid from the connective tissue, filling the gingival sulcus and thus forming the gingival crevicular fluid. Morphologically, the junctional epithelial cells are flat and aligned parallel to the tooth surface. They are poorly differentiated. The deeper cells and the DAT cells are capable of mitosis and migrate coronally. They have fewer intracellular junctions and have larger intercellular spaces, resulting in high permeability of junctional epithelium. Shift of dentogingival junction. As already mentioned, as the tooth erupts occlusally, the dentogingival junction shifts apically. This phenomena leads to two terminologies, active eruption and passive eruption. Active eruption is the movement of the tooth towards the occlusal plane, and passive eruption is the exposure of the crown by apical migration of the junctional epithelium. This movement of the junctional epithelium on the tooth during tooth eruption has been divided into four stages. First stage, the bottom of the gingival sulcus is on the enamel and the apical end of the junctional epithelium is at the cement to enamel junction. Second stage, the bottom of gingival sulcus is still on enamel and the apical end of the junctional epithelium has shifted onto the cementum. Third stage, the bottom of gingival sulcus has shifted to the cement to enamel junction and the apical end of the junctional epithelium is on the cementum. fourth stage, both the bottom of the gingival sulcus and apical end of the junctional epithelium are on the cementum. Many researchers believe that the first and second stage are physiological stages, whereas stage 3 and 4 are pathological stages. Moreover, in first and second stage, the anatomical crown is longer than the clinical crown. In third stage, the anatomical crown is equal to the clinical crown, whereas in the fourth stage, anatomical crown is shorter than the clinical crown. The junctional epithelium helps in attaching the gingiva to the tooth and makes a barrier, but it allows formation of gingival crevicular fluid, which cleanses the gingival sulcus and also has antimicrobial properties. Thus, it helps in maintaining integrity of tooth and periodontium.